with like lemon. Is it good?
Oh my god. I gotta give it to MRSA. He's good.
Staph infection?
That's his name.
Who the fuck is MRSA?
The guy that works there.
Is that really his name?
Something like that.
You know your life is about the grim when you literally just fucking took a picture of an Oreo donut.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing that it doesn't even taste good. You know? We're going to the Max tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
I know you are. Why?
For actually a couple of reasons. First of all, you know I love that place.
Mm-hmm. I fucking hate Latin night.
No, you don't. It's in you.
No, well, Latin? No, I've been in Latin, but
I don't know. I didn't know.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Never.
Stop it.
Yo, is this Arby's?
I wish.
You like Arby's?
Yeah, but where is it? You gotta go to South Carolina to get it.
Mm.
They have the meats.
You ever had Arby's?
Yeah.
I used to love that shit in college. Yeah. Obligatory handshake. Hi, Sam.
Who said that?
I don't know.
Tay Diggs? Yeah, hi.
How come they love that?
Well,
mm-hmm.
Don't want tonight, don't want to punch me in the face.
Which one?
For Mickey D's.
Mm-hmm. Basically. Doug, you just look like it.
That's all right. I would have let her.
How come? Okay, no.
Go ahead. How come what?
How come minority women love you? That's the real question.
It's not true.
Yes, it is. No, keep it a buck.
I don't know. They don't.
Really?
That's in your mind. You like egg it on.
Do women not walk through me? Women of color. Do women of color not walk through me to get to you?
Maybe once.
In our lives? Or tonight?
In our lives.
Come on. Really? Why do you always gotta cap when the camera turns on? I don't even give a fuck about that right now.
I'm not capping.
It's not capping.
What are you, capping stabbing?
I am, actually. That's not real.
According to you, it is.
Women of color fucking love you. They don't like... they don't like me.
Why are you choking?
Because you know.
Both thought.
It's not a fact. I'm capping. Tell me I'm capping right now. Tell me I'm on bullshit.
I guess. But that doesn't mean they don't like you.
But what is it about you, specifically, that they fuck with?
I don't know. I don't know.
You have no idea. You just never even thought of this shit?
I have, but I didn't come... Maybe, I don't know. It's because, I don't... Really, I have no idea. Maybe it's because they pick up on the fact that...
That even makes sense.
They think I'm Italian.
You are Italian!
No, I know that, but they don't know that. But when they see me, they think I'm Italian, and they think they've seen Bronx Tale, maybe, so they assume that I like them.
So you think because of the way you look?
Yes. Absolutely. I don't know. I think it's... Oh, actually, I have an idea. I think it's that whole daddy thing. And black girls love that.
Black girls love what?
Like that daddy thing.
What is the daddy thing?
You know how they call me daddy? You know, daddy.
You think black girls never call me daddy?
No, I know. But, like, I don't know, like, to call a white guy daddy is different.
What?
It is.
How? Wait, what? Because you're like, what? Like, you're not an absentee father? Is that like some racist shit? Like, what the fuck is that?
No.
What do you mean then?
See?
I'm not paying attention to that shit.
I just saw it.
I'm serious. What? Because I'm black, I can't be zaddy? Because I'm zaddy as fuck.
I didn't say you weren't.
So what you finna say? What you mean?
When a black... Look, stop. Stop it.
Because you said, because you're a white guy, that they like you more on some daddy shit.
Yeah, well, you asked me. I don't know. I'm telling you. It's
like, I'm curious. You know, look, it ain't got nothing to do with this, got nothing to do with cat. I'm actually... I'm legitimately curious.
Nah, yo, no cat.
Yeah, no cat. No other cat. So why do
you... It's different when a black girl calls a white guy daddy, yes. And it just like it's different if a white girl called a black guy daddy.
Really?
I think so.
Why?
Because I'm racist. You know that. No, I'm not racist, but
I know that. You, I mean, you're borderline, but
it's like it's like that interracial thing. Like, it gets them off when they say when they see a white guy as daddy.
But you think that because has to do with...
I believe black girls have white guy fantasies, even though they might not admit it. Just like a white girl has black guy fantasies. And the Spanish girls are just stuck in the middle having all kinds of crazy fantasies.
That I agree with.
Yeah.
But I don't think it has to do with the daddy.
Yeah.
I don't think it's more because they're not supposed to have fuck with you.
Yeah, no, that too.
But that's not daddy shit.
Yeah, but at the same time, though, like, they're not going to skip over you to go say hi to...
White girls skip over you all the time.
No. The black girl. Who's the guy that you showed me, that soccer guy? The guy that we saw tonight. It was a soccer guy.
Sergio Ramos.
Yeah.
Okay.
I would like to think they're not going to skip over you to go see him.
He got bread.
The guy at the bar?
No, Sergio Ramos.
No, I'm talking about the knockoff.
Okay. Oh, but you're talking about like Fugazi
right.
version.
Does he, I don't know, but you're not a black girl, but does he look like daddy to you?
No, I'm not saying black girls don't like me.
No, I know, I understand that. But I'm talking about the white daddy.
What do you mean? So you think because you're white that they enjoy calling you daddy more?
No, I'm just, look, since day one, I've been called daddy in here by some black woman.
I get called daddy all the time, though.
By black women?
Yeah.
Oh, well, my theory's wrong, then.
I'm just curious what your thoughts about it.
That was my thought, but I guess I don't know.
I don't really think it has to do with the fact that, like, the daddy issue.
So, I was actually called a dad tonight, and I feel like girls like their dads, so it's the dad thing.
You think girls like their dads?
Daddy's girl? It's just different when it's from a guy that maybe they're attracted to. They always say, girls are going to marry somebody like their dad, you know?
You're going to marry someone like your mom.
That's what they say.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I'm probably not going to get married, so it's flawed.
I don't think like...
See, Schrat sounds like he doesn't like black girls.
She's just trying to antagonize me.
Oh.
She's just mad. I don't know why.
Dad's like oatmeal. That's right.
You are eating oatmeal.
Exactly. Too. See what I'm saying?
So that has nothing to do with your white.
Yeah.
I actually don't like the daddy shit. I don't want a girl to call me daddy. It's weird as fuck.
No, I would get married. I'm not saying, not anytime soon. Let's just put it that way. I do believe in marriage.
So do I. I just think it's bullshit.
Yeah. Like, there's a way to go about things, and a lot of people settle, I think.
Like McDonald's, bro. I don't like the daddy shit, to be honest.
Why not?
I think it's a turnoff.
Why?
Because if some girl calls me daddy, I'm going to think of my dad. And that's just fucking weird.
Well, maybe you're going to look inside yourself.
No, I just think it's fucking weird, bro.
Yeah, I mean... I didn't even really know it was a thing until it started to happen.
What, being called daddy?
Yeah.
I've been called it. It's not a turn on, though. I don't like, oh, call me daddy. I think there's some people out there that actually, like, get turned
on
by that.
They get turned on by that, yeah.
I'm not one of them.
Yeah.
Like, I'm gonna think of my dad while I'm fucking digging.
But it's also a thing, like, young girls do that, too, you know? So if you're with a young girl, they're gonna look at you as daddy. Mm. I get the whole thing. I tell you what's weird about... It is weird. I'll tell you what's weird is because the age thing, though. That's like, I never saw myself... When someone calls you... All right. When girls don't realize, when you get called a daddy, mm-hmm. like, you're old at that point. Like, there's no 23-year-old guy walking around getting called daddy. As a joke, maybe.
I've had girls do it when I was 23.
If a Spanish girl said it, it's different. Because
no, because it's Poppy. That's different.
Exactly.
Poppy's not daddy.
That's
I'm talking
what I'm
daddy.
Right. Exactly.
I'm talking daddy.
I get it.
Like, hi, you daddy.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't really... And that's not... I would say, honestly, nah. Because, it's mostly black girls with the daddy shit. Oh, wow.
Look, I'm a level with you. I never really gave it any thought, and I don't know why black girls like me. All I know is that I guess they do.
I just think it's crazy.
It is. I think it's funny.
No,
it's
I
funny
mean,
how the white girls
a lot of black dudes don't like the fact me. A lot of black yeah, a lot of black guys don't like the fact that like you know you're like on some G-Eazy shit.
Oh, I
no G-Eazy intended. But you know, I'm just saying that you have always had appeals towards women of color.
Yeah, it's weird.
A lot of black dudes don't like that. It's you know, just like if a white woman likes me, a lot of white guys don't like that shit. You know, because I'm black and they don't want the penis. But I understand. But I encourage that shit. You know me. I'm like devil's advocate.
Yeah, who cares? I mean, you know my thoughts on culture. Because I'm a walking hypocrite in your eyes. But it's hard to understand. I get it. But hey, salute. If you're, look, if you're attractive, you're attractive at the end of the day. Hmm. Right?
Yeah.
Bottom line.
Absolutely. I never saw color when it came to him. I just always found it funny that black women seemed to be more attracted to you.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, anything. I never really cared about, like, if a woman's dope, she's dope. I don't really care what she is. I just always found it funny that if we...
But maybe it's us. Is it really that weird?
Yes.
Is it?
Yes. Eat when you want. Doesn't matter. It's not common. At least I think so. You got broken up with and you're sad as fuck. You be alright. You be alright. You're tough, right? You can answer that.
I usually don't use that. Unless it's from like a song or a movie line.
I wouldn't say you have the approval. I mean, you're blacker than most black people, but I wouldn't really like I just like, okay, like your ghetto pass, like you got 60% ghetto, so you can say it. It's just a bunch of McDonald's, man. I'll post this shit tomorrow. I don't pin on weekends. I'm just eating. Do you think it's annoying that like non-minority women try to talk to me?
No. Absolutely not.
I know a lot of white guys don't like that shit.
Well, because they got a problem within themselves.
But haven't you really, like, always been, like, an advocate of, like, you know, I don't know how to say this shit out loud.
Say it!
Like, sticking to your own...
Yeah. But at the end of the day, I'm not going to lose my cool if it goes the other way. Who am I to say anything? That's my thing. Sometimes I have a conflict within myself because sometimes what I believe and what I think is right are two different things.
Contradictory as fuck a lot of times, actually.
Yeah, exactly.
Nah, bro, I still eat one meal a day, man. Nothing's ever changed. You can't just pop back on Instagram and be like, yo, where have you been? Like, where the fuck have you been?
That's a good question.
Answer it. You can answer that more than I will.
What would it take for either of you to
settle down? What would it take for you to settle down so you can, like, get married? Because I feel like people just think you have to get married.
Exactly.
So what would it take for you to get married?
People? I don't think... All right, let's talk about that for a second. I don't think people realize what marriage really is.
These days, no.
No.
Grain of salt.
No way.
Yeah. Yeah.
How can people always sound like the tall crook? Since you know what's what. All right. What was the question again?
What marriage, would it take for you to settle down? Because I feel like people just think, like... They, like, look down on it if you're not married or some dumb shit like that.
Okay. Here's my thing about marriage.
I'm listening.
I don't think marriage is a checklist. I don't think marriage... I think marriage is literally... You meet the person you're supposed to be with. Like, dating websites. I know people have gotten married off dating websites and all that, and maybe it's worked. But I don't think that's the way to go, because... I think when you meet somebody that you're supposed to marry, it's like a...
You just know?
I don't want to say miracle, because that's like too strong of a word. It's exactly, like you just know. Like, you're just gonna... Yeah, you're just gonna know. And it's gonna happen when you least expect it on some supernatural type thing. That's
very endearing.
That's the best way I can explain it. Like this.
Is it a goal of yours to get married, though?
No, it's really? Not a goal of mine. I mean, would I like for it to happen? Of course, I would like to lead that life eventually. But at the same time, I'm not going to settle down, because when you settle, you're going to regret things. Simple as that. Everybody settles to an extent, but it's got to be a settlement that you can live with.
Yeah.
Right?
I don't think I'd ever settle, to be honest. I wouldn't get married unless I literally thought that woman was perfect. I mean, perfect to a fucking perfect extent.
See, I don't think anything's perfect.
I know, and that's why I truly don't see myself getting married anytime soon, because when you talk about marriage, that's forever. Like, that's like till death do us part type of shit. So right. If I'm going to take that kind of fucking plunge, I need to be 100% sure that there's absolutely nothing that I would ever even get tired of. That's what marriage is to me. I think marriage at this point is just fucking stupid. Like, why can't you just be boyfriend and girlfriend for the next 20 years? Why does it fucking matter that you put a ring on? I never understood that part. Like, if you love somebody, and I, you know, I'm not like the biggest lovey-dovey type of tight dude, but if you're legitimately in love with somebody, does it really fucking matter if you put a ring on them? Like, does it really matter? Or is it just you want to say you're married?
But you know what, though? That's the problem with today. It's funny, because I was thinking about this yesterday. I get why there's a contract. I actually get it. I never thought
legally binding.
Yeah, but there's more than that. Mm-hmm. The contract should be between you and that person and nothing or nobody else. It's saying that everything is reinforced behind this ring. But people take that for granted. So therefore, the ring and the marriage contract, because of divorce, it's so easily broken. So therefore, the contract has become nothing but a government thing.
I feel like people only want to get married for the status of saying that they're married.
Exactly. That's one big part of it. I agree.
I feel like people just want to say they're in a relationship so they can say they have a boyfriend or a girlfriend. Right.
It's like climbing the ladder within your business.
As in other words, like you're like not enough of a person if you're single.
Yeah, well, that's all.
Somebody said before, they were like, oh, I never see you bringing girls home. Does that mean I don't talk to women?
That's just
what I'm saying is that's what, like, people look at it like that.
Well, that's what separates you, like, from other people.
I'm just speaking in general, like, American, not even American, just worldwide. Does it matter what you do, or does it matter what people think you do? I feel like for a lot of people, it matters what people think.
Perception is
what? Is reality. So people think, like, oh, it's dope because people, that's why dudes will lie and say they slept with somebody that they didn't even get anywhere near. Because they'd rather say that they did it. Whereas I've always been the type of person that, like, I don't care if people know what I do. I care if I know what I do.
That's all that should matter at the end of the day.
But most people don't. They'd rather cap. They'd rather stunt for whatever it is. They'd rather act like they got a bank account worth of six figures, drive a fucking $100,000 car, but have nothing in the bank and live at home. Whereas, like, the real people who have wealth, and this is a completely different topic, but most fucking wealthy people don't act wealthy. When's the last time you seen Bill Gates with a gold chain on? I got a gold chain on, but you know what I mean? Like,
because wealth is not a characteristic. But people want to floss and try to act like something they're not.
Create a perception.
Own who you are, and you're going to go places in life.
I stay telling people that I'm broke. Because I am. I don't have money like that.
Exactly, because you got nothing to prove.
But I'd rather say that than cap. A lot of people would rather create an illusion. You know, like, people looking like, oh, is this chain real? Like, motherfucker, my house is real. It costs more than a chain. You know what I mean? Like, this chain don't mean shit. I got a house, bro. You know how many chains it takes to buy a house? And that's how people think of shit, though. Like, how many people you know, and I know them, that drive expensive-ass cars and live at home?
Forget about it.
$100,000 cars living in mom's house.
Collecting welfare checks.
Yeah.
Because the money they spending is on the materialistic
stuff. On that bullshit.
Exactly. Priority.
So, in the same breath, people would rather cap and act like they, like, are actually doing shit. I don't care how many women I've ever talked to in my life. I never put my business out there. You will never hear me specifically state that I have been with so-and-so or not with so-and-so or, like, because it doesn't matter. It just, like, I'm not doing it for the outside perception. I'm doing it because I like that person.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
But most people don't do that shit.
Listen, 7 billion people in the world, not everybody's going to think alike, right?
But why cap? Why lie? At the end of the day, if someone thinks you're a millionaire and you're not, is that going to help you in the long run? You know what I mean?
I mean, why lie for the simple fact that eventually you're gonna run out? Exactly.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
You can only cap so much.
Yep. No cap.
I always wear a cap. I have a beanie on, but...
You're a beanie man.
Sima. It's just a bunch of McDonald's, man.
It's a
bunch of Dunkin' Donuts.
Man, I got the hiccups from this bad boy.
Because you're drinking it too fast.
It gets me every time.
It's fucking carbonated.
I know. Frankie Carbone? Yeah. We got off topic. What were we initially talking about?
I don't know. Spider?
Spider to be better. Spider to be better.
Donuts are not good.
Donuts are very good.
I mean, fake it till you make it is pretty much the same thing, yeah. Like, but some people will don't even care about making it. They'd rather just want people to think that they're doing it. You know what I'm saying? Your age. Daddy. New followers, do you only eat once a day but a huge meal? Yes. Is that guy homeless?
Yep.
I shouted you out on my business page today. My people love you. Slay, how you doing? Long time no CC. All that matters is lying. That's my truth. Like, the fucked up part is I've had people actually tell me that it doesn't matter what they do. It matters what people think they do. Sam's not eating because he finished his food already. Because he eats like a Rottweiler. Like,
yeah.
It doesn't matter how much wealth they have or anything. It just matters what people think they have.
People want to be something that they're not in some way, shape, or form.
But shouldn't you aspire to be better?
Aspire to be better. Yeah, exactly.
So shouldn't everybody want to be something or not?
No. Absolutely not. Really? You know better than that.
But I always want to be better than I am.
But that doesn't mean you're being something you shouldn't be.
Do you want to settle down someday? That's the question. That was always the question.
Oh, okay, right. Do I want to settle down
someday? Do you want to?
Yes, I actually do.
Okay.
I do want to settle down one day. Yeah. But I have, believe it or not, for the first time in my life, I actually, you know, kind of have a vision of what I would like that to be.
Mm-hmm. But not, that's going to make you more selective.
Yeah, of course. You know, that comes with age and wisdom and everything.
Exactly.
But, you know, I always knew what I wanted, but it's more real. As you get older, it's hard to explain.
No, not
to me. You know what I mean?
No, of course not.
Like,
I think the older you get, the more you start whittling down characteristics where you're like, Okay, I can deal with this. This is something that I want. Yep. This is something that I don't want. And that's what always happens to me.
Yeah.
Like now, I think my bullshit tolerance is much lower. Like if you do some funny shit now, I'm out.
Yeah.
I don't even fucking think about it twice.
Here's the thing. You know what? One thing in life is inevitable for every human being. From the time that you're born to whatever age you live to, you're gonna gradually change. Whether it's every 5 years, every 1 year, every 6 months, or every 10 years, people change. So now take somebody that was married at 21.
Mm.
You're gonna be different when you're at age 31.
But some people don't change.
No, everybody changes. You know that.
For the better or for the worse.
No, that's a human fact. Like you're never gonna be the same person. But
you can get worse.
Unless you got locked in a room for the rest of your life, very hard to change. Yeah, you can get worse or better. But a change, like Sam Cooke said, a change don't come, right? It's going to happen. So now it's hard enough to live with yourself in the changes. Now you have to factor in a significant other. So now when two people are both changing during a marriage, factor in kids, how are you supposed to make that work? In 1950, it worked because you had to.
Yeah.
Now, people are independent. Women make more money than guys today. So when that change happens, if a woman's married at 21 years old today and she's not liking the situation with her husband at 28, what's going to stop her from running? She must have a firm belief in that marriage. You know what I'm saying?
It's easy as fuck to cheat now.
It's easy to do anything, right? It's easy to get tempted. It's easy to cheat. So you're married 10 years and now you're going from 18 to 28 years old and you're going, man, if I had the choice, I don't know if I would have done this.
So with the sign of the times, do you think that people are getting married too young now?
Yes. That's very, yeah, exactly. So what I'm saying is, at least get the young changes, if that makes sense, out of the way. And then when you reach a certain age, you should have an idea of where you're headed and who you want to head there with.
The average age of people that have children now has gone up. It's closer to 30 now. It used to be much closer to 20.
I think that's smart. Only because, like you said, you hit the nail on the head, it's a sign of the times. If it was 1950, different story, different life.
How many fucking people can afford to take care of a kid in New Jersey at 20 years old?
You can't. No. On one salary besides? No
Even
way.
Even two.
Right.
Most people, their parents help.
Exactly.
You can't take care of no fucking kid these days.
Yep. You know, and
So you think you should, but, I mean, your biological clock is a fucking person, man and female.
Yeah.
It's ticking.
Yeah.
You, right. It's hard to have kids at 40.
It's hard.
We're both in our 30s.
Yeah.
We ain't got no kids.
I get it. But
I'm still not pulling out.
But at the same time, you have to weigh both ends and say, do I want to have a kid at a, you know, how can I say it? Exactly. Yeah. Do you want to have a or
stop.
Do you...
I'll fucking don't stop. Dead. I'm not close to done yet. You have I'm to not... wait till I have one sandwich left.
All right. I'm going to wait till you bite it and I'm going to go. I couldn't think of who shot myself. Once upon. Yeah. You just got to. I don't know, man.
Aspire to be better.
Hey, yeah. Aspire. That's the. Look, if you take anything from this, aspire to be better.
Aspire to be better.
Carry the kettlebells from one end to the other.
You push the thing the football's where you push.
Push the thing football guys. Football guys push. Yeah, I don't know. Does anybody on here watch Chris D'Elia?
Oh, boy.
I know. Of course I'm not one. That's that white shit in the... Oh, what's
it's
the
white sauce.
No good. Don't ever have it.
This is kind of District 9.
It's no good.
You sound like 50 Cent.
Move your pants to your head.
You don't want to have children with just anybody.
Exactly.
Most people choose. But a lot of people don't. A lot of times it's an accident. Most people don't worry about when they have into whatever you want to call it. You know?
Here's another thing. For me, personally speaking, plans have never really worked for me in my life.
Shit.
And that sounds... Pretty it might sound like part. A cop-out, right? But, like, I just... When things happen out of your control left and right, you just kind of take it and you
fucked
go...
Out here.
Exactly. At some point, you look at yourself and you go, why am I going to plan if it's not going to happen? Right?
I don't plan, you know that.
Yeah, I mean, as much as I still try to, it just still doesn't work.
Planning is fucking
missing. You feel me, Slay Slade? I feel you too, girl. Because it's just like, you gotta live every day in the moment.
I would rather that's have a kid because I forgot to pull out than actually plan to have a kid.
Right, because that's how it's gonna happen anyway.
As stupid as it sounds, the thought of having sex for procreation purposes sounds really boring.
Yeah, I understand. Like, cause it's what you're supposed to do.
We're gonna have sex on Wednesday so we can have a kid.
Hey, my guy Pedro, listen, dude, planning does not work for me. It don't work.
No, but anybody who look, plans to do that kind of shit,
listen to
what?
Me. You have a plan A, right? People have a plan B, not the pill. Then you have a plan C. I go all the way up to about H, dude. All right, I'm just telling you, dude. I know it's stuck. Mm-hmm. You know, I have to have up to an H. Why? I don't know. Call it genes, call it God, call it karma, whatever you want to call it. It is what it is. I'm not going to lie to you.
Who are fathering kids at 52?
Forget it. Mick Jagger just had one at 60-something.
No, forget it. Those guys don't count.
But that's what I'm saying. Listen, if I'm going to bang out a kid at 53, salute to me and the one that's taking it, right? You win. You lose, you... Nah, I didn't say it right. You still win.
No, you actually had it.
Yeah, I had it. You win, you lose, you still win at that point. Raise the baby yourself. Atta girl.
Would you give, save us a couple?
No, I would not give them a child. That's weird. That's so weird.
Is it?
Yeah. Because, like, I'll look at that guy in the face and I'm going to go, hey,
that's my fucking kid.
That's my.
Do you know what a hassa is?
Kid. You're raising my kid.
What if they offered you the bag?
And then I would say, move a few bags. You get to, hey, no, absolutely.
Even for the bag?
No.
So yeah. Somebody offers you like 50 racks for a kid.
That would be very hard to turn down, but you know me, it's, you're not going to convince me unless I want to. You know that. You know that.
What if you just had to like do it into a cup?
No, because you know what? I got to look
at... You can't erase that
shit. I got to look at this Jatrul in the head and go, hey, that's my kid.
You might have done that already.
It's possible. No, I didn't do that.
I thought about it.
And look, and God bless anybody that does it. I think it's a great thing. If somebody, God forbid, needs it, you give it to them, salute. For me, it would, no, all jokes aside, it would take a lot. I don't, come on, that's weird. That's, think about that.
But
think about the outcome.
No cap, I have been propositioned to give someone my sperm.
It's weird.
Like, in the last year.
Yeah.
More than once. And I've said no, or I don't, you know.
Yeah.
Because it's the same thing. Like, I'm going to have a kid that's mine walking around, but he's not going to know.
Exactly.
So when he turns 18, what's he going to do? He's trying to find me.
Forget it.
He's like, how can you tell me? Well, listen, kid, both your moms didn't want me involved. They just wanted the sperm.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Weird.
No cap.
What if it was somebody that even you did know? Still, come on. You got to look at these parents in the face.
I'm just going to give me... I mean, I don't want, man... I think there's some propositions where you might actually consider that shit.
Wait, time out. You mean to do the dollar bill and do it?
And like they were like, but come I want on, you to fucking.
No, you, I can't do that.
What if it was think like, about I it. Always use her because we both know she's dope. What if it was J-Lo?
If, wait, come on, that's not real.
It is real.
Yeah, J-Lo's going to find me and go, hey, Sam, okay. I hear black girls like you. Do you want to have my kid?
No, I want you to fucking not pull out.
Look.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay, but that's okay, like...
what if it was like not J-Lo, but one of them? Exactly,
but,
okay.
But wait, does the husband know?
No, she's not married.
Then it's a
she's not married, she's not married.
Oh, she's not married.
Single.
That I might do, yeah.
So you
but,
mean,
but I would be like, listen, I gotta be in the kid's life.
What if you said no?
Then I would be like, no.
What if you had to wake then up every morning like, I'm pulling and make breakfast for Nikki?
I will make that kid pancakes and ask him why it's good for him.
So you would have a platonic baby with somebody?
At this point in my life, I probably would, yeah. Yeah.
What if you had to turkey baste it, though? Nick, I'm going to say it. This is last week. Nick V.
Where he is? What was I saying?
I'm saying Nick V to
yeah, but why? I forget. Someone was named that. Histavicavidius, yeah. Histavicavidius.
I will choke on my fucking McDouble.
Give it a Heim.
Yo, Nick. Nick's going to get married. He like loves it.
Yeah, he's into that shit.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah. God bless. That's
so
great.
You would have a platonic baby with somebody? Doesn't that sound
think
like
about
fun?
How fun that was. Just going to say that.
Does.
Think about it, because at this point you're throwing caution to the wind. You're going, listen, you want to do this?
No, if they're good. Like,
if they're about, like, yeah, forget it.
And honestly,
that's actually best case scenario.
The doper the chick,
that's
the,
BCS.
The less fucking.
That's BCS today. Best case scenario.
Full championships.
Without a doubt. Stop. Well, that too. Yeah.
How come it doesn't matter? And like, if a girl's dope, like she gets away with shit like that.
Well, because that's just salute. She gets. That's the whole point. That's why she's dope, because she gets away with it.
The prettier you are, man and female,
yeah,
the more you get away with shit.
Absolutely. It's a shame. That's how society views stuff. You know that. You know.
So, because a girl's dope, you would be like, I'm not pulling up.
Yeah.
So because true!
That's why you're in there in the first place, right?
Yeah, but you don't want to have the kid.
Nah, I have the kid. Look, if I'm 23, no.
No, but we're at our age. We're 30. Yeah, we're both, exactly. You know, you're 33, exactly. I'm 32.
Because you ask yourself this. You go, okay, am I, at what point, nobody's ever ready to have a kid.
No.
Right? So you're at this point, you're going, I can handle it, right? Because now is like the time you should be doing it anyway.
Is it?
Yeah. 33? Come on.
Why should you have a kid now?
See, we're lucky because we can push it till we're 43, 45. Look, Mick Jagger's pushing him out at 70.
Stop using Mick Jagger.
The guy's pushing him out at 60 and 70.
Guy's still doing shows this fucking 70.
I know.
No,
but that's because he's a representation of what's what. You tell any of these guys at 60 to bang it out, unless they're on Cialis or something, they're doing it.
I mean, guys in their 30s on that shit.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, no, without a doubt. Without a doubt.
But I pull out all the time. In general.
Well, you know how I feel about that, I think. That's sometimes better, you know.
could pull on.
Griff, oh.
Don't knock them.
What? Okay. I'm just telling you what's
I know.
All right. That's fine for me. It's a win-win.
You're going to open a fucking Pandora's box. You
yeah, I'll is. Open up her box, all right.
I'm just all right.
Yep.
You're going to open a box up.
Grandpa has his last... This one's grandfather had his last at 60.
Honestly, I'll still be fucking at 60.
Salute to El Padrino.
There's no way in hell I'm... Are you going to stop fucking at 60 years old?
God willing. Listen,
if you're able...
Aspetalun. I hope I make 40.
If you're
Are you
there,
kidding me?
If you're alive.
If I yes, of exactly. course.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Dude, I'll be shooting zinc, dude.
You hope there are condoms. Can we be honest since we're all in here?
You go down to the store.
Condoms fucking suck.
Miserable.
You gotta do what you gotta do. Don't get me wrong. But they're terrible. Ugh. It's like not even enjoyable. There's a fucking baggie.
Man, what are you gonna do?
There's a literal baggie over your fucking shit.
Yeah, sure.
Like a baggie.
Sure.
You have a fucking, right. fucking...
You got rubber. You're wearing rubber. Think about that.
I didn't even like the smell of it.
Lambskin. Yeah.
I'd literally rather not do it sometimes. Yeah. It makes it not enjoyable. Mm. Does it not? Seriously. Okay. I don't want to get too whatever, but let's just say, and I'm sure you've been in this situation, like, you're getting hot and heavy, right? And you have to, like, be like, you know, oh, yeah, you ready? You ready? Wait, hold on a second.
Go get that thing.
And then you gotta fucking go get it. That's like the most awkward moment in the world when you actually have to put it on. Remember you're sitting there and you're like, hold on, I'm gonna wear you out, hold on. And you fucking, it's backwards, right? You're gonna open it.
Yeah, forget it. It's the whole, you know.
Man, I can't stand it.
Look at this one, loves it, look.
I'd rather not. I'd rather wait until I didn't have to have one.
I feel you.
No, my man fucked up in the head. I'd rather not. It's like a baggie. It ruins the mood. No, I'll kind of wear you out. Terrible.
I know, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do, right?
No, I'm not saying don't. No, I know. Obviously, look, unless you're completely at trust and where you're with somebody who's what, like,
yes.
Absolutely, wear it. Like, be what you gotta be. But at the end of the fucking day, like, they're terrible.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody knows they're terrible.
Sure.
You know, and then they have the other ones now. They got like the fucking diaphragms and the rings and the shit. And... You ever have one of those fucking rings?
No.
I do those. Weird.
It's gotta be weird.
You hit it. Like, legitimately hit it.
Yeah, see. At that point, what are you doing?
Okay. Let me tell you about this. This is the weirdest shit ever. They have these rings, right?
I remember, sorry. Go ahead.
Like birth control rings. Okay. First of all,
they go in there.
Yeah, fucking. They keep them in a. Okay. They have to keep them in the fridge.
Yeah. Put them in the freezer with the meats.
So you go get like a fucking Gatorade and there's a fucking box of. No, right. Fucking rings that go in your.
2-ton Tonys in there, yeah.
Daddy. What do you do? So they got these fucking rings and they're in the fridge next to the fucking milk, right? And then you gotta slide them up in there. So when you actually get into the schematics of like doing this shit, you legitimately will hit the ring over and over and over again.
I thought you were talking about something else. Yeah, I know.
And then they got the fucking nerve, people, because there's probably two or three, and they're like, can you feel that? Hell yeah, I can feel that shit. It's not enjoyable. It's not enjoyable. And I don't even know how diaphragms work. Like, I know what it is,
yeah,
but.
That I don't know what's what.
It's a dish. You.
No, I know what it is.
I know what you know what it is, but like, how does that, what are you doing? I don't know. But they got rings in the fridge. Well, you hit the ring repeatedly. And then feel good.
Yeah, I know.
No, you don't know. I know.
Yeah, no, I do know. No, that I know.
You've done that? You told me.
I thought you said a diaphragm. That's different, is it?
No, because I said before the rings. Have you ever done it in
the
ring?
No, the ring, yes. I thought you said a diaphragm. No, I know, that's...
Yeah, but the ring doesn't protect you from STDs, man. You gotta be careful.
Yeah.
No, you gotta be careful with that shit.
That is weird.
You gotta be careful. I know a lot of people that don't realize that shit. For some fucking unforeseen reason, you know, they're like, okay, I don't wear protection because the girl's on a pill. Like, that's not gonna stop you from getting the STD, you fucking idiot.
Apparently they ain't worried about that. They're just worried about procreating.
I don't think they're... Yeah, but they're like, you gotta be careful, man. People these days, they got fucking instant AIDS, bro.
God forbid.
I'm totally not reading it out loud, because that's clickbait. Wait, Nick? Nick? Did you just say what I think you said? You read that, right?
Yeah. It was. I remember what his last name was now. It was that guy Gus. Gus Giffley-Davidis from Charlie Wilson's War.
You know how fucked up this is? Not lying. Yesterday, I laughed.
Why?
For 30 minutes.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't. At what?
Viggo Mortensen. So you just said that a chick likes to lie and tell people she doesn't have herpely-herplies just so they can dig her out. I'm not kidding you. I think it was the movie Richard Gere.
No, don't.
No, because
I can't take Richard Gere. Stop. I hate that movie. I hate.
Why is Viggo Mortensen in all those movies?
He's the worst.
But he's also in the one with the fucking perfect murder.
Yes, he played like.
First of all,
he's not even good.
No, terrible. But they think he's like.
They think he's that. Yeah, like he's this guy from Spain or something. Get out of here. Your last name. You should last name with the greatest field goal kicker ever.
First of all, his number first one. Name is Viggo.
Viggo. Right. That's first, like.
No, that's where T-Pain takes you.
Right. Exactly.
Viggo. Viggo.
Right. That's like a Russian guy going, "Come on, Viggo now. Get out of here. Viggo this way."
No, what? What? What the fuck? Hold up. Miss Ari? She won't tell anyone because she's scared about her having herpes. Little girl just said. Honestly, if I had it, I'd probably lie. So, you would purposely cap to give dudes fucking herpes.
This isn't
because you got herpes. That's... Ari, I hope you're still here. I love you. On Viggo. What? That's beyond me. I didn't say you had it. But what you just said was you would actually cap.
She needs to get called in. She needs to hear this.
This is exactly why I will double bag the shit out of my shit for the shit. Yeah, hypothetically though, I wouldn't hypothetically. Like, if I had herpes, I have to tell the shit, listen, I'm flamed. It's a wrap. But that's why. Because people will cap. And they will say they don't have nothing. Oh, baby, I look clean to you. You know, I have had people tell me in their lives that they didn't actually wear a strap because they said the girl looked clean. I swear, on God.
Slay wants to lie to you.
Slay wants to lie. You need to defend yourself.
Yeah, that's right.
It's more common than I think. Okay, I probably thought it up in my life a lot more than most people, but I'm not finna cap with the meat. Viggo.
It's easy for people to do the wrong thing. That's simple. You can say all you want, but coming down to it, people are going to make the wrong decision, man. Because it's easy.
To fuck without a rubber and give somebody herpes?
Shit, today?
How do you sleep at night?
Easy.
Viggo.
Simple.
Oh, by the way, Nick, this is for you. This is a pumpkin donut. We had this last year.
Bumpkins?
Nick was like, oh, this is great, fucking 10 out of 10.
He's Gus Nikovitovis.
You actually said Nikovitovis.
That's his name.
You're fucking Viggo Mortensen.
You are.
I'm done. You're fucking Baby Please Don't Go.
Baby Don't Go. Baby Don't Go. Yo, remember? Was he Drake? Remember?
I'm going to eat the Oreo one first. Remember? This is an Oreo donut. Oreo, really great.
Remember? Wag do I, she's six. What? What do I do, she think? What? Didn't even get a try. Nick, he's Gus Vickovitovis.
Stop saying Vickovitovis. Stop! I'm a spit. Yeah, I can't. Just, every time I finish my meal.
He's from where?
Australia.
It's impossible.
No, he's Greek.
He's Greek. He's got to be, but why is he little?
He can hear you.
No, he can.
He's Greek, but he's Australian.
That doesn't make any sense.
No, they do, because you know what Australians do.
Yeah, but I'm sorry. That's Gus Vickovitovis.
It's a
awesome. Fisery, what?
He hears every word you're saying.
Nah, Nick, you thought you heard. You don't hear nothing.
The mic is fucking picking that up.
Mike's awesome.
Nick, bro, he's been... Nick coming back here this year.
Awesome.
Well, you're going to mispronounce his name in front of him.
No.
Because he's Australian as fuck.
No. I know. That's why it doesn't add up.
I'm just telling you. He's going over and over again. He's a Sacer Australian. You're going to be like, wait, what?
I know. We spoke to him one time, and he was with...
Yeah.
What's her name?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
F. Well, he's going to get drunk this time. Because last time, he came and ate with me.
Listen, Nick, dude.
Dude.
Yeah. Oh, that looks good.
Yeah. That's just crazy, the Oreo.
I want to hear my name pronounced. Nick, I can pronounce your name.
Go ahead, tell him.
Perfect.
Tell him.
We have an inside joke. I'll tell you when you
tell him, Vigo.
Tell him what. He's got to make a video of this. Does he know Tom Hanks?
Does he? I think only Australians know, like, Mel Gibson.
Yeah.
Mother floorboards.
With a floorboards. Black, using too many napkins. Standing in the cursing. Looking and staring at the mannequins.
You're in the stammer. Did you actually eat a donut?
Yeah, I did. It was amazing. I had that
one. Okay. No, that's a bit fire. This is actually really good.
I've actually had that one before. It's amazing.
And it's like mushroom.
Marshmallow. Yeah, it's mushrooms in there. Fun guy.
Playing.
Blackins. Chaps like a nap.
What is a Blackin?
Blackin.
What's a Blumpkin?
Stop.
Got Blumpkins. What do you mean? Stop.
Just stop.
Let me luck your cream.
Oh, okay. Let me luck your cream. Out.
Let me luck your cream out. No. What y'all been saying?
Slate. These girls fun. They know they love getting their own doggy.
I don't think anybody said they didn't like it. I think they more said they don't want to get an STD. I think that's where the discrepancy came in. Blamikins.
We're going out tonight. Yeah, we're going right now.
Are you?
Mm-hmm. Love Puerto Rican food.
Yeah. That's all.
Yeah, the food.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
You want some fucking sofrito in your shit.
They
all do that.
Pocahontas. Bet you she is, too. Come with NJ. Can I meet you and Sam?
No.
Tay the realist. Woo! Come on down. Come
oh, that is good.
Come meet. How good, right?
Mm, that's really good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You can answer that. I'm not answering that.
No, you can answer that. Good morning.
I've never had an older woman. No, you did not just low-key do what I just thought you did.
Yeah.
You son of a... She's only 3 years older than us.
Mm-hmm. That's it?
No.
Nah.
Not then. Are you splitting the donuts? No, I think I'm just going to eat them all. I'm fat.
That's impossible.
Yeah, no, I don't believe that.
Slade, come on.
I love how you say your bowl every time.
Slade.
There's no way. Unless somebody working in a chicken nugget. There's no way. I don't believe that. Baltimore? Where's that?
Baltimore.
What that?
We're Don Flamenco.
Are you going to visit Australia?
Yep. We're going to see Gus Vigavitas. It's chilling gay. Hey.
Who's this?
That's so... Vicky.
My boy Nick in Melbourne. What's his last name?
Priest. Vigavitas? He's Gus.
Stop.
What's Gus? Why is
how do you make me just stuck to my teeth?
Why is he Gus?
I don't actually choke on anything. It gets stuck in my fucking teeth.
Yeah, but why is he Gus?
Stop.
All right.
Sam said yes and Dave said no. That sounds about right.
Yep.
It's Sammy Claus.
Yeah.
Not me. Because I'm leaving my business. You know what I mean? I don't even know what y'all talking about, to tell you the truth. I probably said no, because I don't say yes to fucking anything. Besides Nick Vividivis.
He's gonna take advantage. Here it goes.
How'd you do that?
Exactly.
No, but how did you sound like Tonto? You just made a fucking, like a call. Like, that's like a Mel Gibson movie. Like, wake up, like, he's like, how do I fucking stop?
Noah, he doesn't.
The only people that say that are black women that try to smash. That's the way they try to low-key trigger me, is by saying that I don't like black girls. Every time! Like, yeah, nah. I've never had any brown sugar in my life. I'm black as fuck, but I've never, like, fucked black chicks and all that. Not all say that shit. White women don't say that shit. Spanish chicks don't say that shit. Only black girls say that shit, but they say it to you, too. Like, Sam don't like black girls. Like, why come to, what am I, why?
Because that's the line, right?
That's, like, the end of the pickup line of all pickup lines. Nick, eat this.
Well,
because
that's what... Well, that's what, right? That's what you say. They're gonna come at you like that if they like you, right? They make fun of you.
They look at it. Why is it every time? This is a spider donut, which is just a regular
spider,
ass.
Spider to be better. Stop. Right.
not though.
It's Karate Kid.
It's like Last of the Mohicans.
It's Karate Kid.
Forget it. You do that again. I'm gonna go. That's it. No, I don't like black girls. My mom's black, but I don't like black chicks. Black chicks are unattractive as fuck. What kind of dumb shit is y'all talking about? You're just mad because I ain't never tried to get a chew, which I understand. That's the black chick pickup line, because y'all say it to him and he's white.
Trying to smash Sam?
I feel that.
Come on, Tay. Where you at? Where's she from, Tay? You know Tay? You know Tay?
No. DJ Tay Slay?
DJ Tay? Tay Slay?
How come this is good? Mm. But it's a regular ass, dry ass donut.
It's the top.
Sloppy?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I need some of that. I need like a fucking
top.
I need like a jump off. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like somebody who's just like, I don't even want you to talk to me other than. Nah, I didn't see nothing like that.
Yeah, you're gonna see something like that.
Never bring no bitches back from the bar. Let me tell you something, bro. If I ever brought a girl back home from the bar, you really think I'll put her on a fucking live stream? It's dumb, bro. That's why y'all be getting brought up. Never, ever. I do need a jump off, though. I feel like these days, everybody's really trying to, like, fucking, like do funny dating shit. And I'm not about that shit. You know that. That's it. See? That's what it is. They understand what it is. They want to have sex with me, but they want to make love to you.
Stop.
You understand? Because they already know. Don't come to me with that like love shit. Like, I'm out. That is so whack. Mm. You like that shit, right? I'm like a hooker, but like the boyfriend experience.
I want to make fluff.
That flavor of love?
No. Fluff. I'm gonna reinvent the game and call it fluff. How do you know when we're done?
It starts counting down. You got about 7 minutes.
Oh, because you usually when you do that when it's yeah.
What do you want to do though?
Yeah, see? This guy knows.
I'm not like opposed to that. Like, I'm like a hooker. Like, you know how they call hookers that like do certain shit like the girlfriend experience. I think I'm like the boyfriend experience. Cause like, I don't mind showing affection. I just don't actually like you. Which is fucked up. Like, I like you, but not like you forever. Like, I just like you now. But I'll keep it a buck about that. Keep it a buck! You know what I'm saying? Cause this is iced tea. We finna do something in this Law and Order SVU. I don't like pumpkin spice. You're gonna eat the jelly donut instead. And that's the fucked up problem, is exactly what she just said, is why I think women always try to, like, talk. You're not going to change me. I'm not about that. Like, I'm fucking 32. I'm not 22. Like, at this point, I know what I like. Y'all ain't finna change my ass. And y'all think y'all going to change me. And that's the fucked up part. I can tell a female that she's not going to change me, and they still try to change me. I don't want to be your boyfriend. Like, I don't. I think it's dumb. I'm sorry. You can come over, we can make out on the couch, and do all kinds of freaky shit, but I'm still not gonna date you. Cause I'll never make me. Yep, I wanna change. You got, my life is not a Ryan Gosling novel, bro. Like, that's not me.
When you dress like him.
When have you seen that motherfucker?
You dress like Ryan Gosling.
When you see him wear a flannel.
Right now.
No, jelly donuts are fire, bro.
They are good.
You know what I'm saying? They are. Like, we can hang out and I'll show mad love, but I'm not finna tell you that I'm dating you, bro. Like, fuck out of here, bro. That shit's corny as fuck. Oh, this is my girlfriend? Get the fuck out of here. You would just cook for me. I got the dinner thing down pat. I need some mouth. That's it. No woman can make you change, but you can wake up and want that shit on the daily. That means I have to date you for that? That's dumb as fuck. Hmm? At least some people understand. I'm not here for that shit.
Hey, why is that funny?
Because that's... Why people want to know that more than anything, though?
Hey, to the Italian dude.
Hmm? Do you... Yes.
Hey, the Italian dude. Why come everybody wants to know that?
Because that's the culture now.
Know that. Right?
That's the culture now.
Yeah, you can come date me, baby. I like your bunny ears. What you got? What is that in there? What you got? Smell like Escape? Calvin Klein?
I think Enrique Iglesias.
What a culture.
I can't believe all these fucking donuts, too. That's lit. Because I'm skinny in my bed, man. You know what song he likes?
Joe Budden's version is so much better.
That's it.
Right?
Commitment issues. I've been fucking with the same guy for fucking 6 years. We're good.
Hey.
You know what I mean? Guys, he's like basic bitch. Y'all be swearing that shit. Really, I feel like they just try to antagonize you. Like, they're like, oh, he don't like black girls. Okay. I don't like Snapchat filters. I think that's unattractive as fuck, so you know what I mean. Not everybody is built where they need to fucking be in a relationship. I'm way too sure of myself to be in a fucking relationship. That's your problem. Y'all validate yourself based off of who you fucking. I don't even know fucks. Y'all are mad. Y'all be sitting around saying, I need a boyfriend. I don't get no fuck. None.
Your pumpkin's falling apart, right?
That's gonna be you tomorrow. You heard me.
Oh, stop. I'm gonna stay up. I'm not sleeping.
Yeah.
No, you have. I don't think you have an idea.
Yes, I do.
Jasmine Bajwa. I don't know. I'm just. Why is that funny?
Bajwa. I know!
Yes!
No, because people said it's from the father of a child.
Stop. That was crazy. How come that's cool?
Oh, we out. It's been on you.
Almost.